Thanks, sir.
Steady whipping and sipping, flipping my shit when it's written, popping my lyrical clipping. I burn the trees, you're clipping, flow like the Navy midshipman. This shit is gravy, Thanksgiving connections gave me a shipment of that white girl, no shitting. Whip it up in the kitchen. Now it's crack that I'm spitting for the land on top of the mitten. Take a look at my wrist. And
it ain't playing, take a show.
Yo, 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 yo!
Hey!
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Get the fuck on my back.
We're back. We had to skip a week. We were way too lazy last week.
It's been too long. Yeah.
I was literally just sitting here just like, nah.
I just didn't feel like doing it. I feel you.
Fuck it.
Sometimes you just
I hit you too,
then
you were
around.
Like, you were like, I'm already doing something
yeah,
too. Something.
I was like, yeah. I waited long enough until I was like, oh, he hasn't hit me up. I'm going doing something else. I didn't feel like doing it anyway. So
I didn't feel like doing that shit.
Yeah, so we were on the same page. Hey, man.
It's the motherfucking Meant to Be podcast. I'm Bash.
I'm George E. Motherfucking Crack Rock.
And JG's in the building again.
The E stands for motherfucking egg salad sandwich.
Whew. Yeah. Wheezy F. Crack Rock.
But, we got Johnny in here. Fucking J Ugly to the maximum.
He's
sipping his goddamn fucking iced coffee like a
fact
grown
checking.
Man.
Fact checking, cap checking. We want to start with your motherfucking gay ass lines or what?
2019, don't say gay.
Oh.
I still call women bitches.
What are you supposed
so you
to call them? What are you supposed to call them?
I'm just kidding. Wait, no, you don't call my team gay. Come on, come on, 2019, you don't use that in that term. If people are gay, they're gay, but it's not a gay team. They're a fucking. A team of
oh yeah, they just like smacking each other's butts in the locker room. That's all. Good game, bro. They won. So
I bet
your
Bears are in there fucking sticking fingers in each other's butts. You're gay ass. All right, team.
Let's chill.
Fucking me. We're about to get canceled. I don't give a shit. Anyways,
can't be canceled.
The fucking Lions won 3-3-1. Fucking going to the fucking Super Bowl. No, I'm just
3-4 basically.
Fucking Christ. Matt Patricia, your defense sucks fucking balls, bro. Like, what the fuck, dude? And they didn't even make a fucking trade at the trade deadline to fucking help their fucking team out, throwing in the fucking towel. Matt Stafford's having a fucking career year.
Is it too late?
No.
Like, overall?
No, it's not. Oh, yeah, now it is.
What about free agency?
Well, no. Well, if somebody's in the free agency.
I don't know how it works.
Yeah, well, yeah. Free agency can be whenever. But trades, it's done.
You gotta stop shaming me for not knowing. You just gotta like let me know. Like that one podcast, I was like feeling like a dumbass. He's just like, nah, motherfucker, you don't know shit. And I was like, damn, all right. Yeah, I don't.
You are a dumbass though. You feel like that every day.
That's true.
Well, dude, I'm gonna explain football to you right
now. Yeah. I'm sure there's people watching that don't know either.
I was like a dog chasing the car just now. I didn't want you to say you wanted me to.
Is Bridgewater, is he a free agent now?
No, he's the backup quarterback.
That's who I want. Mitch Trubisky's got to go.
Oh, no. He's still a backup for the Saints for, I don't know how long he's signed for, but yeah.
Mr. Throw 10 yards every single fucking play.
You guys traded up for that bum ass motherfucker. Hey.
We over Mahomes, right? And
yeah, I was just gonna say that. See, Jesus, you know some things, motherfucker. Christ. And then that makes me think that you know a lot of things. So I'm sorry. Fuck, I thought you were smarter than you are.
I do my best. I fucking watch a lot of shit. Do a lot of shit.
Yeah, I feel you.
Oh, Packers beat KC
without Pat Mahomes.
And not so much referee help too either.
No
shit.
It was a cleanly called game. But you guys are lucky that they didn't have Pat Mahomes, you fucking clowns. You guys would have fucking lost. Fuck y'all. You guys ain't gonna douche in the playoffs either.
I don't know. They look pretty good.
Shut the fuck up. Be on my side.
Well, I want to be a little bit unbiased. Like, that pass was fucking crazy.
Dude.
That was a nuts pass.
For real. Matt, or fucking Aaron Rodgers. Falling,
getting tackled, fucking in the corner. Like,
as much as I talk shit about him, that motherfucker is a good-ass fucking quarterback.
Yeah.
You can't fucking deny it.
Like, he's really good.
If you deny that, you're just a pure fucking hater and you don't even like the game of football.
That's what I'm saying. I like to be a little unbiased when it comes to stuff, you know?
Yeah.
Like, the Lions are gay, but, like, they're still pretty bad, you know?
I'm gonna die at this man's knees after he's
literally been trying to bring a fucking sign, but he's too much of a stoner to remember for the past like month and a half.
Well, I actually remembered a couple weeks ago, but we were on a fucking losing streak and I was like, yep, I'm not putting this bitch
I think
up
I remember
right
you
now.
Saying that.
I was like,
yeah.
No, fuck that. This ain't the week to do it.
Bruh, we predict the future.
What's that?
Cleo motherfucking Matic in this fucking, bitch.
Fucking meant to be Stradamus and shit.
meant to be Stradamus. NCAA football.
The fucking goddamn NCAA voted to fucking let the players profit off their likeness. Thank you.
Fucking go. What was that last podcast or the podcast before? Go. We said, oh, I can't wait for fucking, I hope they fucking do another video game. And look. Lo and behold,
I've still been playing fucking NCAA 14 on PS3. So fucking don't come at me.
I know,
I've been waiting for
too.
This for so long. To this day, fucking motherfucker.
Even when you had a PS4, you're still playing that shit. It's like,
yeah.
But I have missed playing fucking basketball bad. I hope they come
NCAA,
out with that.
Dude, NCAA basketball games were so good. They used to have NCAA baseball games too.
I don't give a fuck about baseball.
I fuck with baseball games. Fuck I haven't baseball. Played a baseball game in so long.
Baseball games are fun, though, actually, because yeah. You got to, like, swing.
Dude, you know what's fucking dope? Fucking soccer games.
I've played
I fuck
it.
Fuck with FIFA heavily.
They were fun.
And NHL games.
I can't keep up with everything, like I was saying. Like, you love sports, but I have so much shit that I dabble with that it's like, you know. Yeah. I know a little bit of everything.
Dude, I feel like I'm just a dumb fucking motherfucker, because I know, like, a lot about a lot of things, but it's only like surface level. So I'm just a half a fucking meatball. Like, oh yeah, I've heard about that, but I know nothing about it. I know exactly what you're talking about, but I don't know shit. Fuck.
Which, that fucking, talking about video games, that new Call of Duty came out, and I literally have played it every day for at least like 3 hours.
You all right?
At least 3 hours a day. Smoking
fucking nerd.
Smoking fucking cigarettes.
That's a damn shame, bro. And you quit. You quit for
Let's not get
long?
Off this though. Fucking new Call of Duty, bro. It isn't the same as the past 12 years,
meant
bro.
Meant to be podcast listeners. Bash needs to quit smoking cigarettes.
Smoking fucking cigarettes.
Anyways, yeah. Fucking Call of Duty. Yeah.
Watch it's fucking crazy. Games. It's based so
this man plays on a PC, he's a nerd.
Yeah.
Nerd.
I love being a nerd, to be honest. It makes me happy.
Hey, man. Fucking A.
Shit.
I'm sorry, then. I'm sorry for making fun of you for something that makes you happy. That was wrong of me. That was a bad friend of me. I shouldn't have done that.
But they're using the engine from Battlefield, but it has Call of Duty, you know, everything from Call of Duty, but it's just a different layout. Completely, like, everything's a lot more there's bigger maps, the guns are better, like, I don't know. You gotta check it out. If you haven't bought it yet, you should. I wasn't even gonna fuck with it. I bought it because I was bored one night and I didn't think it was gonna be any different. I just wanted to, because I seen people were getting in, I was gonna go play with them or whatever. And then I bought it and I hit Johnny up and I was like, bro, you need to buy this shit. Like, instantly. And then he's been on it every day with me, too.
Nerds. No, I'm just kidding. I'd be on it, too, if I had a system, but I don't got one. We used to fucking nerd the fuck out. Bringing in fucking three fucking TVs into that tiny
tournaments.
Ass apartment.
We should soon. We could do it here.
Dude, a 2K tournament.
I already got fucking four TVs in this room right
but
now.
The thing that sucks is motherfuckers in Berga is like, holy, all the way in Houghton? It's like, it's not what do you mean all the fucking way?
Me and Johnny went to Milwaukee one day on the fucking strength.
Just because.
Bought a car and shit. But yeah, that's dope. Check it out. And then Adam's going to buy it tax time if he didn't get fucked over again.
Oh, speaking of fucking tax time, riddle me this. This year, I couldn't get my fucking taxes because I didn't have the right identification. And then they said something on the form about a credit card. So I got a fucking credit card. Still couldn't get my taxes. I'm like, okay, I got to go in there and show my face or something. Fucking show my fucking birth fucking mark under my ball sack or some shit to throw on me. Anyways, I couldn't get my taxes. A couple days ago, I get something in the mail about owing on income taxes in 2016. It's like, motherfucker, this year I couldn't get my money because you didn't know who the fuck I am. But in 2016, you knew who I was.
They probably, they probably are supposed to owe you. You know what you have to do? You actually,
pissing me off.
The thing with fucking government shit is, if you're not persistent, super fucking persistent, and annoy the fuck out of them, that's what they do it for. Because they know a lot of people won't. You know what I mean?
And I'm the type of person that will not. I don't even try to go to the doctor.
That's a lot of money. Honestly.
I didn't get my taxes for this last entire fucking year. I fucking worked my ass out. What the fuck?
Fuck yeah. I'm putting everything on my shit this year. Because I was given game by a fucking... Okay, so there's this girl that is a gold medal Olympic medalist at Michigan Tech. I gave her dad, when he dropped her off, a ride back to the airport in Marquette. He was giving me all kinds of game. He's like, you could write off literally basically anything if you have an LLC. Okay. So I was like, shit. He's like, you could do this and this and you could write this off. I was like, ooh, getting a big one this year for sure. Fuck that.
I wish I had a dad.
Same, bro. Same. It's okay.
I'll leave us in here.
Son, where'd you find this?
I don't know. Fucking dad, where'd I find it? Don't fucking call me son. I don't know you like that. Fucking call me son. No, just kidding.
I heard during the holidays this year, the fucking PS5's coming out.
Bro, I'm still playing PS3.
So...
I'm not getting no PS4.
Yeah, you are. Eventually,
I still need to upgrade to fucking PS4. I'm still selling ditch weed. I haven't even upgraded to good weed or cocaine yet. Like, fuck, man.
Wait, you said selling. Let's get rid of that real quick. Cut that. No, I'm just kidding. sell weed.
I don't sell nothing besides this ass.
Get at me.
Only fucking black MILFs.
Shit.
Shit, the fuck. Piggy, don't fuck on my back. Piggy, don't fuck on my back.
Oh, man.
No, I'm just kidding. I'll take white males.
Shut the fuck up. We're keeping that, too. I don't give a fuck.
Let's go.
Next
victim.
Stupid as fuck.
Are you crying yet? Biggie, don't fuck on my back.
Hold on, I'm trying to find out what the fuck this one is. There we go.
You're a piece of chicken, you fucking cock.
Alright, what's up? What do we got next? El Chapo's son!
Dude!
Out here mobbing.
That's fucking extreme gang shit.
Busting shots.
This motherfucker was fucking arrested for 2 hours. And they fucking started raising a ruckus.
Hell.
And busted his ass out of here.
Hell happened.
If you don't have that energy, I don't want you part of my gang.
They literally started a war in Mexico.
That's crazy. Over it.
Yeah, they were.
And no, it's crazy. They should just legalize all drugs, and that would have never happened.
I actually did some research on this one. So literally, fucking the cartel had too much fucking weaponry for the Mexico's government to fight them.
That's crazy.
They're literally stronger than their government. We need that energy, bro.
A lot of their government is on the cartel side, though, too. They're paid off. Dude, the cartel makes so much money, I guarantee.
Well, they have to be, right?
It's pretty much a fact.
They basically have to be, because if they weren't, shit's going down.
For real. Want to talk about some petty gang shit? Your boy Russ and his homeboy is fucking beating up. They jumped another fucking rapper. Come on, Russ. Square up one-on-one.
Okay, so look, I want to say this about it. So I honestly was critiquing him, like, he has that song, the flute song or whatever, and it was like fucking, I got my team with me and they fight. And he said, bitch, I fight too. I was like, oh, for you, like 5'6", bro. But
motherfucker, I'm 5'7½". I fight. No, I don't actually. Mm. I just dive at knees.
But so he literally, Guapdad 4000 said in his song, he's like,
first of all, who the fuck is
get
that?
What Guapdad 4000 said up.
What the fuck is Guapdad 4000?
Yeah, exactly. He's giving him more clout than he needed anyways. But this
sounds like a robot.
Basically, all these little rappers, these fucking Guapdad new age, 4000. They're not Kendricks, J. Cole's, or like tough Jay-Z's or anything. It's always these little fucking zanny fucking popping, fucking lean drinking little fuckers that are like, fuck Russ and blah blah blah. And this guy said in his song, he said fucking call that Russ. He said, you're super successful, but nobody cares. Call that Russ. And so Russ, he went up, he went to go talk to him about it. And Guapdad said, oh, I was on the phone, I didn't want to. If you see someone that you just dissed in a song coming up to you, what the fuck's gonna happen? Like, you just, like, that's what I mean with these little rappers. They're just like suburban kids, basically. And they're like, oh, whatever, you know. And then pop, punched him in the face. And then everybody started fighting. Russ's people, like, started beating up Guapdad's people.
It was like Guapdad's people was like four people and fucking a little white boy.
Doesn't matter.
It does matter because there's fucking
If you start beef, we've been having this conversation about everything. It doesn't matter. There are no rules.
Oh, yes. But I'm saying don't act like you fucking beating somebody's ass when you punched him one time and then your fucking crew went and beat his ass.
Yeah, but Guap, did you see the video or not?
Yeah.
So he punched him and then he got pulled back and Guapdad was running into the fucking RV. Like, scared.
Well,
like,
I didn't look into it that deep, but like, I don't know. I just seen a punch and I just watched the video. And bopped midair.
Oh yeah. Dude, like those Call of Duty shots on the
jumping out a window and you just get blasted shot in the head.
Yeah. Like, oh, he's got it right here.
Here it is.
Just getting mobbed. I love that. I love it because everybody, people just think they can talk shit about whoever, but then there's people that are actually do something about it because they get away with all these people, right?
Yeah.
Not just this one. I'm not talking about Russ in particular. I'm talking about people that just talk shit about anybody, but then there's always that one person that hears it and they're like, fuck that, I ain't let them talk shit about me.
That's going to happen on this podcast because I'd be talking shit about everybody. I'm
fucked. But you got MTB, though. Shit.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm just kidding.
What else we got to talk about here? Shit, we're running through this too fast.
Yeah, for real. Holy.
Goddamn. But we restarted the cameras once or no? So this is only 20 minutes. We are going crazy right now.
Well, let's fucking pause
Johnny
this.
Just swagged out right now. Supreme fucking Patagonia fucking Nike. Oh, Air Force Ones. That means he'll beat your fucking ass.
We ain't gonna pause this? Freeze.
Pause.
5 minutes later. All
right, we're back.
Ah.
Had to smoke a fucking cigarette.
Had to smoke a fucking blunt. No, I was already too fucking spaced out and fucking going off on tangents. I just had to pee.
Where were we even?
I don't know. We'll just jump back into it. Have you watched any new movies lately?
Nah, just COD. Single day.
Fucking nerd. Well, have you heard of the movie Midsommar?
Nope.
Fucking watched that the other day. It is so fucking
mid.
Good.
Summer.
It's good as fuck. Have you watched Hereditary?
No.
Jesus, Mary, and fucking Joseph. Hereditary is like one of the best fucking horror movies in the past like fucking decade. Dead serious. Fucking ask your mom. She probably knows. I'm just kidding. That was wrong. I shouldn't have said that. Anyways, but it's about like these people going to like
Midsummer.
Can you just let me?
Yeah.
All right. These people.
All right. Go ahead.
I'm gonna dive at this motherfucking knees. I'm not lying. Anyways, they go to like Sweden or some shit. I think it's Sweden. And like go to like this fucking old, like timey fucking community, and it ends up being a crazy ass cult. I don't want to say anything more.
Carnivorous?
No, not carnivorous, but like, oh, they actually do fucking mushrooms in the movie, which is kind of dope. But like, I don't know, you got to watch it. It's fucking.
No, really?
For real? No, I'm serious. It's good. I don't know how to fucking explain it. Fucking cut on the goddamn preview for it or something. And then you can fucking look at it. It'll tell you something about it.
Well, just tell me some shit about it. You just said I was bad at explaining shit.
I am bad, but then fuck.
You got to get around it without Midsommar.
S-O-M-M-E-R.
I spelled it wrong on there.
It's fucking Finlander shit.
Finlander shit?
Scandinavian, Finland, or Swedish, either way, it's all the same.
Yeah, Norwegian. Pretty much the same area.
Bunch of blonde-haired, blue-eyed, hit fucking weirdos.
We're just going to watch this as it's going.
And we can't hear it. Fucking dumbass motherfuckers. Cut that off, fuck it. Anyways, let's fucking talk about it.
That's the kid from...
With the eyebrows, the redhead kid.
Is that the kid from the Breaking Bad Breaking Bad and Alchemist?
I hate that motherfucker.
Me too.
No, I know who you're thinking of. That's a different guy.
Oh, yeah.
This guy.
What's he from?
Fucking.
Looks like fucking the dude from Toy Story.
Dude, yeah, for real.
He's not, though.
I know. In fucking real life, he dressed up as Sid from fucking Toy Story in real life. Actor did. Yeah, he looks just like him with the fucking pointy ass eyebrows, all ugly as hell.
The fucking kid that kills the toy, or fucking just Frankenstein's the toys.
Yeah. shit. Anyways.
But you did very bad at explaining.
That was bad. That was very bad. That was very, very, very bad.
I don't want to hear shit then. Don't give me shit about explaining stuff anymore, because that was terrible.
Wasn't it?
Holy fuck, he looks like a fucking weirdo. What's his name?
Kind of looks like you.
Will Poulter.
Poulter?
Yeah.
The fuck? Put a geist on that shit and this motherfucker's haunting your house. The fuck motherfucker's called Poulter?
That was perfect. Shit.
Shit. Let's talk about our fucking favorite albums.
No, we're not talking about our favorite. That's next podcast.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because we didn't write them down. We just wrote albums that we know.
Right now, this second, let's say our favorite albums, but then next podcast, we'll do some research.
We'll do a top three for each one of us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right now, my favorite is definitely Bandana, Freddie Gibbs.
Why?
Because it's so fucking smooth. My stoned ass was sitting there, was like, God damn, is this still the same song? Looked in there, four songs deep. I was like, holy fuck, dude, this shit is smooth sailing.
It's a piece. One piece, yeah. Madlib produced that whole thing.
Yeah.
Yep. Motherfucker's a genius. There's supposed to be a Mac Miller produced Madlib album coming out which will be fucking
the vibes
crazy.
Off this album. Could you imagine Mac spitting off that shit?
Yeah, man. Those are my favorite jazz. Mac beats smooth or jazz. Mac That's songs when he does songs like that is on those fucking almost boom bap, but not even. It's like, what would you call that, Johnny? Just like
it's its own thing.
But it true.
It's like trippy boom bap.
Yeah, it has really dope harmonies with the kicks and all that shit.
It's jazzy almost.
That's it, it's smooth jazz, bro.
Yeah, that's what you said too.
Listen to your boy, bro.
You don't know that much about me.
I don't. Just kidding. Sometimes I do.
You do, because you pointed that out and I was like, yeah, that's true. But yeah, that album is dope. What's that song that you showed me?
Fake Names is my favorite.
Yeah,
God Damn, it was his.
God Damn,
whatever. What the fuck, G-A-T. That one is dope too. Yeah. You gotta listen the whole thing through.
Freddie
bro.
Gibbs is crazy.
For real, bro.
Yeah. I like his old shit too. Like his what was that Straight Killer No Filler? That one was crazy, that mixtape.
Hell yeah.
I remember listening to that one. I was like fucking 17, like, whoo!
Out here grinding in Kansas, getting all the white women. Yeah. Corn-fed bitches out there, probably, huh? On Kansas.
Yeah.
On the fucking wheat fields and shit. Nothing but eating bread and fucking cornbread shit. Those bitches probably thick as hell. No?
Nah, flat.
Fuck that. Fuck them bitches then, man.
Now that I think of it, yeah, and there wasn't too many busties.
Bunch of flat ass bitches. Bitches are built like the fucking ground that they're fucking growing on, just a bunch of flat plains. Bitches around here are fucking built like bad. Fucking mountains.
They're bad. There's some bad ones.
Yeah, bad looking, bad smelling, bad tasting. Probably smell like Kentucky fried fucking smelling, nothing.
Perhaps.
What they smell like?
Corn. No, I'm just kidding.
I told you.
Nah. It's not pretty. You know, it's a college town. They're all trying to be fucking something that they're not, so.
These bitches be crazy. Indeed. Can't live without them, though. I love them. I love these hoes. Fuck, I don't know what Snoop Dogg said, but I think I do love these hoes. I'm pretty sure I do, actually.
Kanye, Jesus is King. Ah.
I don't like church. And I don't like church shit, so I ain't gonna fucking even give that shit a fucking chance, bro.
The beats, honestly, I thought the beats were pretty dope.
Yeah, I assume. Kanye's beats are
usually fucking... Oh, you didn't listen.
Fucking, no.
I forgot you
literally,
said that.
One song came on Pandora, and I was like, "What?" I didn't know what it was. I was like, what the fuck is this even? It sounds kind of decent. And I seen Kanye West featuring some. I was like, this is going to be some preachy shit. I want to hear some lean, drinking, Xanax, popping, pussy fucking big old ass dropping type shit. Killing your fucking ops type shit. I don't want to hear no goddamn church.
I don't know the dude personally, but I've actually messaged him on Instagram and shit, but he has like texture packs, sample packs, that type of stuff. He co-produced the song On God on that album, Came One. It's pretty dope.
I don't know what
texture packs means. That beat is crazy too.
Is that like something that you can put on your character on Call of Duty, texture packs?
No, like a fucking on Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator. Like,
yeah, I don't know
what that means. Yeah. It's like essential to most of the stuff that I've been making for my art.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and he has like dope sample packs that he creates the sounds for. Like in depth.
What do you mean sample packs? Does he like use them again or something?
Other sample people packs. Can use them. Like what he does, he'll make the... I don't know. Johnny, what would you consider? Like I think he makes the sounds for it.
A sample pack is just like a file folder full of
sound,
like drum hits and shit.
Yeah,
like
different
like
sounds,
like the basis for a beat you can build off of this or something like that,
or the harmonies, or just like sounds like a key. Like,
yeah, some of them are like that, they have like full loops and shit. But
yeah, I don't know.
A lot
I don't
of it's just like one, like it'll be a
one hit
drum or a bass drum,
like one kick,
yeah, or even like one piano note,
oh, ding, really? Yeah. Just like certain sounds, but yeah, he has like all kinds of those. You can pay for them, you know, whatever. Because there's a thing called Splice now where you could like search for sounds or whatever. But like everybody uses it, so like people like that are honestly probably the way to go if you don't make your sounds yourself. You know what I mean? Because then you have uniqueness in your sounds. But he does that. Co-produced on Kanye's album, bro.
Oh yeah.
Fuck shout out to that motherfucker, man. He's doing
shout
big
out to
shit.
The boy.
He's and then he does like all kinds of dope actual paint art. Like his girlfriend owns
He paints it himself?
Yeah. Like actual art. You know what I mean? I mean, everything's art, but he's like for real.
I think painting's fucking crazy because like honestly I've never painted, but like I feel like if you fuck up, you fuck up and you gotta start over.
Kinda, you could like layer on paint too, though.
Oh, really?
You know,
you can like cover up your fucking...
yeah, white it, you know. But most of those guys don't have to. I agree, though. Like painting's like the fucking actually playing an instrument of music. You know what I mean? But
or drawing in pen. Holy fuck!
Yeah,
there ain't no going back.
Oh yeah,
that.
Yeah, for sure.
That's crazy.
Mm. Motherfuckers are get good. My sister does that. She's really good too. Shay does some shit. You seen a couple of her paintings.
Yeah.
But, so you were on for... You talked about Freddie. Remember
when we were talking about... Hold on. Remember when we were talking about fucking Adolf Hitler being a fucking good artist?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. And then we brought the picture up.
On our podcast, like, way back.
Yeah, yeah.
When Georgie Crack was on probation.
Oh, yeah, Shea versus Hitler.
Oh, fuck.
Man, I ate Sloppy Joe's. My stomach is just gassy.
You are a Sloppy Joe.
Mm-hmm. Sloppy Bash.
I don't like Sloppy Joes, bro.
Sloppy Joes are the shit.
No, because some motherfuckers be putting too much sugar in them sometimes, and they're just sweet meat, and I'm like, nah, I need spicy or something. I don't want just sweet meat.
I don't like the sweetening either, but I do love some Sloppy Joes.
One of my homies one time brought some pizza that his dad made homemade, and the sauce was just sweet as hell. I was like, did you just add a bunch of sugar to it? And he was like, yeah. I was like, what? This is normal?
Like white sugar?
Yeah, regular sugar. I was like, what in the fucking white people is this?
I didn't know people did the white sugar.
They spiced their shit up with sugar. What?
Yeah, I don't like that. That's ugly as hell. I don't like it sweet. I just like some Sloppy Joes because that sauce is good. The manwich.
The shit, when you fucking were making your little sliders or whatever, it looked like spaghetti sauce. That's what I thought it was. Is you guys putting spaghetti sauce on fucking sandwiches without noodles?
It comes in a can. It's like called manwich or something.
I know, manwich. I don't like that shit.
It's good.
No.
It's good.
No, because motherfuckers be adding nothing but sugar. Maybe if they added some hot sauce or some shit, a black pepper to the manwich, it might be good. But in my fucking experience, it's been some... sweet ass fucking Sloppy Joes. I don't fuck with that.
Hey Johnny, you want to come over here and say a couple of good songs off of fucking Kembe X, his album?
Don't cut me off when I'm talking about Sloppy Joes. I'm
fuck Sloppy Joe.
Voices in my head.
Voices in my head. Oh, what's that album called? I was depressed.
I was depressed until I made this album.
I was depressed until I made this album. Yeah, and then that was in like fucking parentheses or whatever.
It just says I was depressed until I made this.
Yeah. Oh, okay. That wasn't in parentheses. Yeah, yeah. And Voices in My Head. That is a dope ass song. Oh, anybody can listen to that.
That's the only song I heard, and that shit's dope as hell.
Yeah, I listened to the whole album. It was dope.
Oh, yeah.
So that was his favorite.
Go listen to the whole Freddie Gibbs album. Then.
Mine's an older album from beginning of the year. Well, somewhat beginning, but fucking Boogie from Shady Records. Eminem signed him.
I think you showed me a couple songs about that, and they're both dope.
Really good. Skydive. Fucking Silent Ride Home. The album's called Everything's for Sale. He's dope.
Fucking.
And the videos are dope. Actually, remember I told you.
Play some snippets from each song we're talking about.
Okay, I'll stop the podcast, put them in there maybe. Or you could just look them up. I don't know. I don't know. The video editing's pretty fucking annoying. You see me over probably. There for fucking 3 hours.
Yeah, dude. I'm glad I don't have to do that. I just sit here and talk and drink beer and then walk away. And then people hit me up. Oh my god, you were so cool on the podcast. That was good. How'd you guys do that? And I was like, I don't know, wizardry.
I figured out who that girl was that stopped me at the gas station.
Who that bitch is?
It's Stuart's sister.
Oh, Crystal. Oh, I'm sorry for calling her a bitch. Yeah, that's my cousin.
Shout out, Crystal. Thank you. That shit was dope because I was just at the gas station. She walks up to me. She was like, "I like your guys' podcast." I was like, "Oh shit, thanks."
Yeah, she at work. We work in the same building, and we were walking past, and she was like, "Oh, I've seen part of your podcast. I was watching it when I was getting ready for work. I like the part when you're talking shit about Aaron Rodgers."
Yeah, yeah, that's what she said to me too. It's funny.
Yeah. Got random people fucking saying that they watched our shit.
I know, a lot of people hit me up, and that I get more feedback from that than the music, to be honest.
That's shit. Just my beautiful face. That ain't you. That's all the crack rock, man.
Yeah, they can't get enough.
For real, man, I got them hooked. Bunch of crackheads on the nose.
Addicted to the podcast. Yeah. Pod crack.
Pods crack. I actually have a verse about, like, bitches are getting addicted to crack rocks. I ain't gonna spit it right now because I'm too stoned.
Maybe we can record it tonight.
Yeah, maybe.
Let's get you an album.
Give me a what?
We're gonna get this motherfucker an album pretty soon, I promise.
I thought this motherfucker said an album. A-A-L-L-U-M.
What the fuck is like, that?
Yeah, I know. That's what I was wondering.
An album?
Let's get this motherfucker an album.
The fuck? Well, in the context we were speaking,
I got you. I just, dude, you know how I am. I fucking listen to people, and when they say something wrong, I gotta call it out. I do it to myself before anybody else can do it. That's, I don't know. I just always hear when people
fuck That's up a good thing, though, because then you don't have, then you can't have the other person saying, you fucking idiot.
Yeah,
you
know, dude, I'm always faster. My jokes are quicker. My jokes about myself are quicker than yours, bitch. I already said that joke. That's what you, as a comedian, you gotta do that.
For sure.
I'm a podcaster. Ugly!
You don't like that?
I love it.
As a podcaster, whose laugh
was that? No, I said I'm a podcaster first, then a comedian, then a cat lover, then a bash kisser, and then a rapper.
Oh my god.
And then a water drinker before a rapper, actually.
I'm going to use your own drop on you.
You're a piece of chicken, you fucking...
That's yours, fuck idiot!
Bigot, bigot, don't fuck on my back.
All right. Wait, let me finish my fucking... Everything's for sale, boogie... good songs are Silent Ride.
No, I'm still pissed you didn't let me talk about fucking Sloppy Joe's.
Silent Ride, Soho, Skydive, Rainy Days has Eminem on it. Whose Fault, Self Destruction, Time. I like every song off this shit, but those are the main ones.
I bet the main song that anybody's ever heard is the one with Eminem on it.
Probably not. He's pretty underground.
Who, Eminem?
No. Yeah, Eminem.
Yeah.
The biggest rapper basically ever because he's white.
Yeah, but we're talking about outside about how this motherfucker promotes himself over anybody he has.
Yeah, you want to go in depth about that real quick?
Do you want to?
Shit, let's do it. Because like Joe Budden talks about on his podcast all the time how fucking Slaughterhouse was signed to Eminem and then fucking they basically got thrown under the rug because Eminem had shit going on at the time. And who else? You were talking about Yellow Wolf?
Yeah, like his albums on the fucking label, they were not fucking that good. But before he was signed, he was making good music. Mm. It's like, weird how that works, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
But like, fuck, I don't know. I don't know anything in depth about it, but like whatever Joe Budden said.
Well, that's what you're fucking referring to, though, is your Yellow Wolf basically went down.
Yeah.
Because I didn't really listen to Yellow Wolf, so I don't really drink that much Mountain Dew.
That's a good one. I don't drink Mountain Dew either, but fuck. I don't know. I was
kind of. You don't dip either?
I don't dip. Yeah, of course. I fucking chew snuff.
Do you?
Of course I do.
Oh, yeah, you do.
No, I don't. You clown.
You did those little fucking packages for a while, didn't you?
The only thing I've ever chewed was fucking Redman, and that's just fucking tobacco leaves.
I swear you did those little packs for a while. Or no, I was thinking of Johnny or something. I know Johnny did.
Johnny was a chew snuffer once.
Snuffer chew?
Snoo chuffer. I remember that. Nasty beast.
I do. I remember that.
Remember that. Remember that with an N. I remember that.
No, I'm not going to go back to that, actually. Fuck this. How much time have we got left? We just talking now?
Let's fucking just end this bitch. We don't need to go an hour. We had a good podcast. Yeah, we're done. Fuck it.
We're good. This is good enough.
We've been trying to blast through this because I feel like we're trying to make a song and it's getting late.
Yeah, true. I do want to say one song you guys should look up. Napkins by RIZLAVIE. It's smooth. It's not hip hop, but it's like chill. Other than that.
It's good shit. Good shit. Said you played it earlier. It's good shit.
Indeed.
Liked it.
It's cooling. All right, though.
You're a piece of chicken podcast.
Damn, son.
Episode 97 or something.
Biggie, the fuck on my back.
It's the Meant to Be podcast. I'm Bash.
I'm George.
What does the E stand for this time?
It stands for anybody can get it with an E.
Anybody.
Any.
Alright.
Fuck y'all. And all the black MILFs. I need y'all still.
Shout out to black MILFs. Our listeners. Black MILFs. I understand if you never want to listen again. We still love you.
I need you.
Because we got your two views.
And I understand if you guys quit watching. I quit watching.
No. I do really like when people hit us up, though. Appreciate it. Yeah. All right. We out this bitch.
We over.
I'm Bash.
Next week, we coming back. I'm George.
I just want the bag, just a little cash.
I just want the stack.
Yeah, I think they big man.
I just want the racks.
No, it's coming soon.
I just want the cash.
Right up in my hand.
I don't mean to brag.
Yeah, I'm doing good,
but my bitch is bad.
Do that bitch is sad.
Gotta take care of the family.
Had them living lavish.
That's why I'm running up the bag.
Just gotta happen gradually.
Slow grind better than no grind. Matter of fact, that shit feels like no time got you. Girl in the whip, world on your fingertips. And it's showtime, pull up through the show, I need a whole nine. And a sure bang, I need stacks, no change. Can't never be a no name, cause I made mine. You can do it too, it's gonna take time.
I just want the bag,
just a little cash.
I just want the stack.
Yeah, I think they big, man.
I just want the racks.
No, it's coming soon.
I just want the cash.
Right up in my hand.
I don't mean to brag.
Yeah, I'm doing good,
but my bitch is bad.
Do that bitch stack.
Gotta take care of the family.
Had them living lavish.
That's why I'm running up a bag.
Just gotta happen gradually.
A lot of people out here faking. This fucker. I stick with my day ones. I trust them. I got love for everybody. Still keep my distance. You can't come around no more. Can't see my vision.
Little bit of juice in my cup. Two pills and I'm rolling up. Remember when I ain't shit gonna say. Fuck it all, I'ma go now. I know it ain't right, but it works for me, baby. Just pray that it don't take your life from me, baby.
I just plant a seed. They tell me I don't need you. I just don't believe.